Hello students, in this lecture I am concentrating the topic on signal to noise ratio. Signal to noise ratio, the communication student must understand this value very clearly. Let us first understand what is signal and what is noise. When we say signal in electronics, it means that any electrical signal, either it is voltage or current or power signal, like that. Okay, and when we say only signal, it means a signal is a noise free signal. Noise means unwanted signal. In electronics, when we say noise means unwanted signal. And when we say signal, it means that wanted signal. Okay, so when we say signal only, it means that a useful data or useful voltage or useful current or a signal is a noise free signal. Okay, now what is noise? Noise is the white noise we hear when we cannot tune a radio to a particular station. If you hear radio in your mobile or in a radio set, in receiver set, then if you are not tuning the channel properly, say if the Vivid Bharati station, frequency is 100.8 megahertz. But if you have not tuned it properly, you have tuned it at 100.6 megahertz or 101 megahertz, then what will happen? You will hear some sound which is not clear to you. And that noise is called white noise. Okay? So that uninterrupted signal, with the noise which is not clear to us when we cannot tune a radio in a particular station, that is considered as noise in electronics engineering when we are going to study the transmitter or receiver, especially receiver, when we are designing, when we are studying the circuitry of receiver or demodulator, then this concept of signal to noise ratio has to be understood in a particular manner, in a clear manner. Okay, so when we say signal means a useful signal, and when we say noise means it is a destructive signal. It is a destructive signal. Noise is a destructive signal. Okay, now move towards signal to noise ratio. In order to determine the strength of a signal, if we want to determine the strength of the signal, what we have to do, it is necessary to calculate what is called signal to noise ratio. If we want to know the strength of the signal, so we have to study, we must know what is signal to noise ratio. Signal to noise ratio means, it means signal divided by noise. Signal means useful physical quantity that should be heard, and noise means unuseful or destructive signal which should be destroyed, which should be completely finished. Okay, so signal to noise ratio means signal divided by noise. Both are audible. In communication system, when we say signal, it is also audible, and when we say noise, it is also audible. Both may be voice in communication system. Both may be voice, both may be voltage, both may be current. So signal to noise ratio will become a dimensionless quantity. Now, since the signal is in the numerator part and noise is in the denominator part, Here you can say in the formula. If this is the formula, this one is the formula. So, thus it is taken in the term of power signal. This signal to noise ratio is equal to power signal divided by noise signal. Okay. So, the signal is in the numerator part and noise is in the denominator part. So, if the ratio is higher, means this SNR value is higher, it means that signal is better or greater comparable to noise. Means signal magnitude is greater than the noise. As I have told that signal and noise both are the same physical quantity. Here we have taken power. It may be a voltage signal, it may be a current signal. So, whenever we write signal to noise ratio, we can write power signal by power of noise. We can write voltage signal by voltage of noise. We can write current of signal by current of noise. So, both are of same dimensions. So, what we will get? Signal to noise ratio, we will get the dimensionless ratio, dimensionless value. And if this signal to noise ratio is greater, it means that this numerator part signal will have a greater quantity comparable to noise. Okay. So, it becomes to detect a true signal or extract useful information from the raw signal. Understood? So, for getting the better quality of signal to noise ratio, this data should be of higher value. Now it is defined as, it is signal to noise ratio is defined as the ratio of power of a signal that is useful information to the power of background noise. And the knowledge of this ratio is very much important in applied mathematics, analytical chemistry, electronics and geosciences too. Okay. In electronics, signal and noise are measured in decibels. In decibels. In electronics, in communication engineering field, what is the unit? Just now I had told that signal to noise ratio is dimensionless. Then now I am telling that it is measured in decibels. How is it? Let us watch. Now, signal to noise ratio is a measure used in science and engineering that compares the level of desired signal to the level of background noise. And it is measured in decibels. Now, if both are equal, power signal is equal to unwanted noise signal, then the ratio will be 1 by 1 and this ratio, if it is higher than 1 by 1, indicates more signal than noise. Okay. Now, as I had told that signal to noise ratio is measured in decibel, what does it mean? It means that the formula of decibel is 10 log base 10 power signal to noise signal. If we are considering only this part PS by PN, then this part is dimensionless. But since this PS by PN value, that ratio is very small, and now we are taking the signal to noise ratio, especially in engineering, with a new formula, that is 10 log base 10. I am correcting my sentence. PS to PN, this ratio is very large, not very small. If we want that power signal should be far greater than comparable to noise, then this power signal must be very large compared to noise signal. Okay, so this value, which is this comparison, if it is of very large magnitude, say 10,000, 10 to the power 6, then in writing the data or in calculating, there may be mistakes. There may be mistakes while calculating, and it will be troublesome to calculate with the bigger data. So one new formula has been derived, and it is written as 10 log base 10 PS by PN. Now what is decibel? Decibel is the smaller unit compared to bell. Now what is bell? The bell is the term derived from the name of Alexander Graham Bell, who is the inventor of the telephone. The unit decibel is used here, listen it carefully, the unit decibel is used because a 1 decibel difference in loudness between two sounds is the smallest difference detectable by human hearing. Understood? 1 bell is equal to 10 decibel. It is just like that we are comparing a bigger unit to smaller unit. Say 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram. So kilogram is the bigger unit and gram is the smaller unit. So when we write kilogram, so the magnitude is 1. So always the greater unit comprised with a smaller value. And 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram. Both are the same quantity, same magnitude. But when we take the smaller unit, that is gram, so always the smaller unit comprised with higher magnitude, that is 1000 here in this case. Okay. In the same case, 1 bell is equal to 10 decibel. Here, log 10 PS by PN. Log 10 PS by PN is denoted as bell. Its unit is bell. But since it is a bigger unit, so what we do, we take a smaller unit that is known as decibel. Since 1 bell is equal to 10 decibel, or we can say 1 decibel is equal to 1 decibel is equal to 1 by 10 bell. 1 by 10 means 0.1 bell. Okay, so this part log 10, this is 1 bell. Understood? This is 1 bell. So what we have to do, I am correcting my sentence. This is multiplied with 10 is known as decibel. Is known as decibel because this part log 10 PS by PN is 1 bell, and it is equivalent to 0.1 bell is equal to 1 decibel. Okay, so here last one what we were studying, that is threshold effect in demodulators. Now if you have understood the concept of signal to noise ratio, here in both axes we are taking here the carrier signal to noise ratio in decibel, and here in y-axis signal to noise ratio at the input of the receiver. Okay, so what we are watching, that this linear rising graph, which is having a constant slope, it is rising, means if carrier to noise ratio is rising, then signal to noise ratio is also rising with the corresponding value. Proportional constant multiplier is there. Say if CNR is raised by 2 decibel, so maybe the signal to noise ratio has been doubled, that is 4 decibel. Okay. So if it is like that rising graph, it means the signal is always greater magnitude compared to noise, because signal to noise ratio means signal divided by noise. But as we are watching in this part here, we are watching in this part that slope is decreasing. It means that signal is decreasing comparable to noise, means noise is increasing. And when we are receiving this flat graph, it means that in this flat portion, signal magnitude and noise magnitude same, which is undesired.